Welcome to WatchGuard's Daily Security Byte. I'm Corey Nachreiner, and today I'm talking about the Dyre Wolf banking attack campaign. IBM released some new research showing a new hybrid attack campaign that mixes both a digital and human element. It's actually based on an old Trojan called the Dyre Trojan. This was typical banking malware. It would infect your PC, install a browser hook, and if you went to one of the 100 banks it knew, it would try to steal your credentials. But this new campaign is slightly different. Basically, the bad guy is sending spear phishing emails targeted at enterprise users that make a lot of wire transfers. If you click an attachment in this spear phishing email, you're infected with another downloader Trojan that will download this new variant of Dyre onto your computer. Now, this Trojan does the same browser hook, and when you go to certain banks, what it will do instead is add a little bit of code that injects a pop-up that says there's some sort of banking technical difficulty, and it asks you to actually call up a banking representative. Now, if you call, this, of course, is actually a phone scam. That banking representative will pretend to authenticate you to the bank, but is really stealing some more additional details from you. And presumably, as more banks enact two-factor authentication, it's harder for digital Trojans to steal all the information they need just from your browser. So this sort of hybrid attack allows a human to get additional information about you. Now, of course, if you did give up your information to this human attacker, they actually start a wire transfer from your account immediately, and in some cases, IBM says they DDoS the victim, presumably to make it harder for the victim to really see what happened on the actual banking site. So this is just an interesting new twist, mixing a digital attack with a human element. So you probably want to know how to protect yourself from this. Well, there's really two things you should look into. First of all, like a lot of malware nowadays, this Dyre Trojan is polymorphic. Its authors will change the binary at least once every 3 days, if not more. That means signature-based AV has a hard time keeping up with it. You need more advanced threat protection techniques like WatchGuard's APT blocker, which can catch polymorphic malware. As far as the human element, I highly recommend you train your users to watch out for phone scams and social engineering. It's pretty unusual for a banking site to ask you to call a number. And when people on the phone are asking you for information, you need to be a little bit skeptical about it. So train your users to be aware of these social engineering techniques. Anyways, that's it for today. Thank you for watching.